Greetings and thank you for the opportunity to come your way, spend a few moments in God's Word and pray with you. We're talking about strange doctrines this week because the writer of Hebrews does tell us in Hebrews 13 verse 9, do not be carried about with various and strange doctrines. For it is good that the heart be established by grace, not with foods that have not profited those who have been occupied with them. So the heart needs to be established with grace and not with various and strange doctrines, which is like food that is of no value, that actually can destroy you. And so we're establishing some criteria, God-given biblical criteria on how to evaluate the preaching and the teaching of the Word. And so we've listed several over the course of this week. And today I want to bring our attention to the importance of receiving God's Word under the inspiration and anointing of the Holy Spirit. That means the Word of God is not being delivered to us purely with the exercise of human eloquence and ability and the ability of the human mind. But rather there is a dependence of the Holy Spirit. There is the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. There is the anointing of the Holy Spirit. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 3, as Paul is speaking, writing to the Corinthians, he says, clearly you are an epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but by the Spirit of the living God. Not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh, that is of the heart. Notice what he says, you are written not with ink. That means not by natural human methods and means. So the presentation of the Word of God is not depending on natural human means, but it's depending on the Spirit of the living God. So it's not about the person's intelligence, or great skill or talent or ability. All of that is fine, God-given, thank God for it. But our dependence is on the Spirit of the living God. So is the ministry of the Word of God coming forth under the inspiration and under the anointing and by the revelation of the Holy Spirit? Is there an unveiling of truth that the Holy Spirit is enlightening, bringing to your understanding as the Word of God is being ministered to? That's important, that the ministry of the Word is by the Spirit. So the preaching, the teaching that you are paying attention to, is it coming to you by the Spirit, by the anointing and the empowering of the Holy Spirit? Is it bringing revelation to you? Is it causing the eyes of your understanding to be enlightened? Is it unveiling the truth that is in the Scriptures so that your life can be ministered to? Is the power of the Holy Spirit impacting your life when you hear the Word of God? That's an important criteria. By the Spirit. Protect yourself, guard yourself from various and diverse strange doctrines, because those things are harmful for your soul. Let's pray. Father, we ask that you help us receive the Word, the pure Word that comes forth under the ministry of your Spirit. Help us to be discerning and to welcome that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.